In this video, I'm going to be revealing to you my 50k per month affiliate marketing blueprint. Now, I want to say up front that I've never really considered myself as an affiliate marketer. It's one of the things that I do as part of my business model where I will always promote my product first, but as a side thing, I will promote other softwares or products that make sense that fills a specific market gap or requirement. And today in this video, I want to be able to show you exactly how you can do the same and to be able to integrate the process of promoting other people's products and get paid commissions in return, and how you can scale that to 5-6 figures a month. Hey everybody, this is Ping Jun here, and today in this video, it's gonna be a few different segments. The first segment is number one, how I think about what makes a great affiliate marketing offer that can be plugged into your business model, whether you have a business or whether you don't have a business. I'm gonna walk you through the different affiliate programs that I feel would be amazing this year that's worked well for me. And finally, the third portion would be the breakdown of what the sales process and what the funnel should look like in order to promote these type of products or programs or softwares profitably. Okay, so I'm gonna show you five different affiliate programs that is recurring in nature. So if you're new to affiliate marketing is just the process of promoting somebody else's product and getting paid commissions in return. And the first requirement that is crucial for me is promoting something that I actually use. Okay, and I think that's actually crucial. I think far too many people try to go into affiliate marketing promoting something that they don't even use or they don't even believe in. And if you want to be good in doing this thing, you got to start off by actually using it, being a believer and a user yourself. Okay, so this first tool is ClickFunnels. I love ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels, if you take a look at all of my different sites, pages, landing pages, webinars, high ticket, pretty much all of them is built in ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels is a software, it's a funnel builder, and that brings us to the second requirement. The second requirement of how I think about promoting these offers is if there is some sort of recurring that locks the user in, because most of these, the really good affiliate marketing programs, they will pay you every single month as long as a person continues being a user. Of course, there are some good, you know, one-off affiliate marketing programs, but the ones that I like promoting are the ones that also not just, you know, help my audience out, but the ones that allows the person to use it again and again. And usually these would be software as a service or SaaS. Okay, so ClickFunnels is one of them. We've generated over $1 million in commissions utilizing ClickFunnels, and it's a great tool. So I want to walk you through five different tools that you could be promoting or utilizing that has done very well for us. And then I want to walk you through how we actually do it in terms of the funnel setup. Okay, so the next one that's really hot right now is Jarvis. I have never imagined AI being good at this skill set. If you have been marketing for over a decade, you know that whenever marketers try to utilize AI in their copywriting, and there were these article spinners back in the day, the outcome is usually horrible. But after utilizing this tool, and in fact, this is something my team utilizes as well in order to generate headlines for our ads and to get ideas, Jarvis is basically a tool that marketers use that enables copywriting to be produced by AI. Now, I think that AI produced content, and whether it's going to replace humans, that's probably not going to happen in the next 10 years at least. However, this tool is a great tool that my team utilizes to help them get ideas when it comes to copywriting, when it comes to headlines, when it comes to the hooks. And they do actually a really good job with leading the way so that it gives you that idea on types of copy you could be creating when it comes to ads that could be on Facebook or Google. So there's a lot more than that. They have AI that can be used for content writing, for blog posts, which I don't personally use. I utilize more for ads and hooks. But this is another one where they will pay you a percentage, which is 30% every single month, as long as a person continues being a user. So for ClickFunnels over here, ClickFunnels has, it's $97 a month. That's the cheapest pricing. And they've got different tiers to it, but the standard recurring percentage is 40%. So as long as a person continues being a member, you get paid $40 a month. You start off lower, but once you hit a specific threshold, the payout will be higher. So Jarvis, similar, it's per month. Now, all of these different softwares I'm showing you, they're all monthly recurring. So that means that as long as a person continues being a member and is paying for this software, you get paid being the person that introduced and referred this software as a service. And by the way, all of the links that I'm talking about, because there's going to be a few different resources, I'm going to put them in the description box below so you can go ahead and check it out after you watch this video. But Jarvis is a great tool. We've seen great results. They have a webinar that is converting really well as well. Jarvis is definitely something that if you're in this market, which is the marketing market, you want to consider. Third one, number three, is something that just literally launched like a week ago at the time of me shooting this video. And this is Passion, that helps audience monetize their coaching business. So same thing here, it's a 30% recurring every single month as long as a person continues being a member. And basically what this does is it gives content creators, coaches, people who sell courses, the ability to market and sell their products in a way that is more interesting, it's gamified, and to build community, their own app. And same thing as Jarvis, they pay 30% recurring per month as long as the person continues being a member. So that means that as long as the person, depending on the plan that they go for, pays every single month, they have got two plans, $79 a month as well as $239. And as long as they keep paying, you get paid every single month. This is a relatively new, this is still a question mark over here. I see a lot of potential. This is not being mentioned yet, but I do believe that it is going to be big. So that means that it's mainly targeting people who is, you know, into whether it's music, dance, yoga, faith, spirituality, parenting. And the whole purpose of this is to make it a whole lot easier for a person to sell their own course, on-demand streaming, to be able to drip content, to create challenges, to make it interactive. And they have done a really good job, and I'm actually very excited to be able to see the direction of where this product goes. So one thing that I'm a firm believer about affiliate marketing as well is that if you are somebody that's thinking to become a full-fledged like affiliate marketer, getting on board when it's relatively newer, when the competition is lower, is also a crucial one. So this would definitely be a big advantage for people to jump on early. Next one, number four, is a tool that I've personally utilized for maybe about 2 years called TubeBuddy. TubeBuddy is a Chrome extension to help marketers optimize their YouTube videos in terms of getting discovered, in terms of SEO. So this is the affiliate program, and how it works is it is recurring every single month. And this is a lower ticket type of item. There's $7, $15, and $40. And just like all of the other softwares that I've shown you, as long as a person continues being a member, you get paid every single month as part of the affiliate program. And that brings us to number five, which is ActiveCampaign. So ActiveCampaign is a software that handles the backbone or email marketing, as well as it's kind of like AWeber, GetResponse. Think of it as when a person collects a lead or an opt-in, they need a way to send out these emails. So they pay out 20% based on a subscription. So that means if they pay $100 a month, you get paid $20 every single month. You will realize that pretty much every marketer would require a software that's similar to ActiveCampaign in one way, shape, or form. So this is a great type of software that pretty much is in demand because marketers would need something like that anyway. And how I think about affiliate marketing is always coming from the angle of, it's not about persuading somebody from a no to a yes. It's always thinking about who are the people that's already saying yes, and how can I place my link in front of them, because they're going to be buying it anyway, so they might as well buy it through me. Based on these five different softwares, of course, we have partnered up with and utilized a lot more softwares, but this is to give you an idea on the criteria of what makes a great affiliate software. Now, before I walk you through the setup and how we promote these different offers and how you can integrate them as part of your business model, important thing is to make sure it meets these criteria, right? You use it yourself, you're a firm believer, it genuinely helps your audience, you would recommend it to a family, friend, a loved one, and you want to be able to hopefully promote something that is recurring in nature, so that's how you can build a passive stream of income. Okay, so in terms of the setup, I'm going to show you the setup first, and then after that I'll show you some actual examples of how our funnels and our sales process looks like. So let's head over to the whiteboard, where I'm going to walk you through exactly how that would look like in terms of the setup. So I believe that affiliate marketing on its own is not a business. To me, promoting somebody else's business as a business is not a real business. So, and that's a primary reason why I don't consider myself as an affiliate marketer, even though I do affiliate marketing. So if you can come from this angle where promoting somebody else's product is secondary, that's when you can look at this setup very differently. Okay, so in terms of the setup, how can you build this as a long-term sustainable business where you're promoting your own business first? Well, at the very least, so think about the offer that you want to promote. Now, the offer, I've shown you five different examples earlier, could be a software that, based on my examples, could be helping somebody build up funnels. It could be helping them with their copywriting, right? It could be on sending out their emails, right? And lead gen. It could be perhaps scheduling their social media. Now, there's a lot of different tools and softwares and services that will enable a business owner or entrepreneur to do something better as a service where they got to continue paying every single month if they want to continue using the software, right? So I've given you five examples earlier. So whatever it is that you feel you want to promote, that's actually what happens over here. The question is, how do you make it so that you are promoting your own thing first? Now, if you're starting out and this is all new to you, this means that at the very least, you should be promoting and sending traffic to this page. Now, what is this page? This is a page that captures somebody's lead, somebody's email, where you're collecting leads so that you really maximize the traffic that comes in, whether it's through paid ads, whether it's through organic, so that you're building a list. Because once you have this list, this is now traffic that you actually own. This belongs to you. So in future, if you decide you want to promote, create your own product and promote it and keep 100% of it, it belongs to you. So that in future, if the affiliate program changes, right? Like, I love ClickFunnels. ClickFunnels has made me tens of millions of dollars. But I don't know if the affiliate program is going to be around forever, right? Why? Because I'm still playing on somebody else's turf. It could be the case that one day the owners decide to, I don't know, exit for a few billion dollars. And maybe the new owners say,
hey, you know what? This affiliate program, we're going to discontinue it.
And I could literally just overnight lose $1 million stream of income. So while I love affiliate marketing as well, I understand that I need to place this thing as priority. So what I'm about to show you soon is the setup of how this page would look like. And in fact, I'll even share this template with you as well. Okay, so what you'll notice over here is if we can reverse engineer what it is that we want to sell. Okay, so think of that thing that you want to sell right now. So maybe is it that social media scheduler? Is it the funnel builder? Is it something that helps people get more leads? If that is the thing that you want to promote, that means what we need to do next is to reverse engineer the conversation that takes place here so that when a person gives us their details, as a way to continue that conversation, this offer would be the solution to the problem that they're facing. Let me give you an example. So let's say I want to promote this funnel building software. Let's take, for example, ClickFunnels. Rather than running ads and sending traffic straight to ClickFunnels, which is what most people do and that's why most people fail, what you want to do first is to think about, well, can I, first of all, niche down? What does it mean by to niche down? What many people try to do whenever they create an offer is they try to go broad. Without realizing, going broad actually weakens you. It doesn't strengthen you. Most people try to go broad because they think it's a bigger market, therefore there's more money to be made. Now, in most cases, if you try to go broad, you end up getting nobody. You want to start off by being the big fish in a small pond, right? And eventually you can become the pond, but you want to be the big fish in a small pond. If let's say I want to promote this software here, I'm now thinking about how can I niche down so that I can speak to a specific audience? Can I speak to people who want to be able to do live events, who are people who are speakers? Do I want to be able to speak to real estate agents, network marketers? So I will decide and niche down on a specific market first. Now, once I do that, so maybe I've decided, you know what? I'm going to go with real estate agents. Then now I'm going to be thinking about how can I give the marketing terminology of this would be like an ethical bribe, right? How can I give them this bribe for them to want to give me their details, which is their email, in order to exchange for this thing? Now, there's the right way and the wrong way of doing it. The right way, what separates the top 1% with the other 99%, is if you can make this bribe sound like it's done with you or done for you, where it feels like it's handed to them and they don't need to go through like 300 pages of content in an ebook, because even though it could be an ebook, it need to be positioned as something that you can either copy and paste or fill in the blanks or to swipe and deploy. A specific process, a blueprint, a swipe file, a cheat sheet, a downloadable, a template, right? Because these words, even though it could be an ebook, implies that it's done with you or done for you. Okay, so that's the bribe. So think about, what can I give out in exchange for their name and email, or at least their email? Now, once you understand this, so what's gonna happen now is I'm gonna build up this page. I'm gonna show you how this page is built out as well. And then I'm gonna walk you through the conversation that needs to happen so that naturally this would be the result. Promoting this offer that could be the software to help you write copy or to send out emails or to schedule social media or to build funnels would be a natural part of the conversation. So imagine now with the real estate example, I now realize that I'm gonna speak to real estate agents. So now, what would this landing page look like? So before we talk about traffic, what would this landing page look like? Well, this landing page would be, I need to have some sort of promise or headline, right? That's the third ingredient. So the headline is usually the promise without the thing that they hate doing, okay? So how to results in without thing that they hate doing, all right? So it could be like, you know, attention real estate agents, how to generate more leads in the real estate market without cold calling, knocking on doors, or handing out brochures, right? So without thing that they hate doing, right? That's the headline, that's the promise. So if let's say I wanna cater to network marketers, right? So maybe it's like how to build your network marketing downline without approaching friends and family. It could be then free training reveals, free template, free blueprint, free outline, free script, right? Reveals and shows you exactly how you can make this happen, right? Enter your name and email to receive this downloadable. So this downloadable is this thing that implies you just need to model it, copy it, fill in the blanks, right? It could be a script, it could be a template, it could be what to say on the phone, right? It could be an Excel sheet, it could be a mind map, it could be a workflow, right? Something that's handed to them so that they can just model, swipe, copy, deploy, fill in the blanks, right? Now, once they do that, this is where there is going to be one bonus page, okay, that's going to appear in the middle over here now, okay? Now, what is this bonus page? So this is the bridge page. The page that is going to bridge between collecting the opt-in and sending people here, right? Because now they have opted in for this free thing, and I'll show you the setup in a second. And this is where it's going to transition over to the offer, right? So whether you want to sell your own offer or somebody else's offer, there needs to be this thing that happens in the middle so that this thing can happen, okay? So now let's go back. Let me show you the template and how this page should look like before I reveal to you exactly the conversation that needs to take place here, okay? So let's head back over to the screen right now and let's take a look at what happens, right? So for example, okay, if I wanted to promote a product that is about social media scheduling, a good way to start and initiate this entire process could be 32 proven social media post ideas. Copy this winning social media angle so that you can get more engagement, leads, and sales now, right? Enter your email below to receive this downloadable. Now, at the very least, this should be the bare minimum above the fold, right? Just headline and the download. If you are hardworking and if you are an overachiever, then you might want to consider having like long form and the elaboration on what this thing's about so that they will enter their details here. At the very least, give you their email, right? So this would be an example of a lead magnet page. So same thing here, right? Let's say I want to promote something that's to do with, you know, marketing or pitching or selling or closing. So I'm starting off the conversation, right? You know, copy my little known secrets to selling online, influencing the decisions and closing the deal, right? So this is where, right? Notice it sounds like you just need to copy and model and fill in the blanks, right? So this is the page. Now, once that happens, once a person enters their email, well, what happens after that? The conversation, right? So the conversation that will take place once a person enters their name and email address is where you want to think about, well, how do you transition and bridge between them opting in, giving you their email, and hey, buy this product, right? So let's say back to the real estate example, if I'm a real estate agent, what's going to happen is I know that eventually I want to promote, let's say, this offer over here, right? And they just gave me their details in order to discover how to get more leads in the real estate market without knocking on doors and without cold calling. So this is where you want to be able to have a conversation. And this conversation has got a few different elements that you want to fulfill. Let me walk you through what this conversation is all about. So in order to bridge people to the next page, on this page here, which is usually known as like the thank you page or the confirmation page, the first one is to acknowledge and congratulate them for getting that thing so that they know that it's going to be something they're going to be receiving. So this would be like, congratulations for getting this template on how to get more leads in real estate without knocking on doors and without cold calling. I know you're going to absolutely love this training, and you're going to be able to receive this in about 5 minutes from now. Okay, so notice what I did. Congratulate them. The next thing I'm going to do is number two. The second thing in the conversation needs to happen is I need to introduce some sort of problem. Why? Because if I want to market this thing, I can't just say, you know, here's what markets do, right? Most people try to sell the thing straight away, which is,
there's this amazing software that helps you get more leads.
And that's when it feels a little bit weird because there's no depth, there's no education, and there's no value that's being provided. So what you want to do is you want to introduce some sort of problem. So that's when you could say, you know, after being in this real estate market for a few years now, I noticed that a common problem that agents usually face is they don't know how to go beyond the traditional methods of doing roadshows, giving out flyers, knocking on doors, and doing cold calls and giving out name cards. And what if I could show you a way that you could utilize to get more leads online and diversify and utilize the latest strategies and build a sales process to help you get more leads that's actually qualified, that helps you convert these leads to sales. So notice what I did, right? Problem. Problem is most people rely on traditional methods. So now what I'm doing is I'm introducing a solution. The solution is to be able to go online, get leads, make sure that they're qualified. And one of the best ways to do that would be this thing called an application funnel. So now I could introduce a solution called an application funnel. And then now that's when I could have some sort of offer. Now this offer could be the software. It could be the AI. It could be the thing that sends out emails, right? So depending on the problem and solution, depending on what it is that they came in for, now there's a very congruent conversation that takes place. That's when I could say, right? And one of the things that I personally use in order to build up this sales process to help me get more leads is product name. And if you want to be able to go check out product name right below this video, you can go ahead and click on it. Now, what do you think that call to action is getting them to do? It's getting them to click on the link, which is basically your affiliate link. So I'm going to put CTA here, which is the call to action. And once they click on that link, that's how the affiliate program can track that you are the person referring the sale and give you the credit, right? So now if you think about it, well, what if they don't buy straight away, which is going to be a good percentage of people, right? Now understand that even if they don't buy straight away, guess what? What's going to happen now is you're still building a list, right? And a lot of people will not buy the first point of contact, right? Maybe just 5% of people buy, maybe 3% of people buy, depending on what it is that you say here and depending on how good or bad the conversion for this specific offer is. But here's the amazing thing. Because you own this now, because this is a list that you own, you could have a follow-up email sequence. You could be nurturing this list. You could be coming up with your own future product in future. You could be promoting other products in future. But as long as you continue nurturing the relationship of this list, this is something that belongs to you forever, where people will follow you as long as you're delivering value and adding value to that relationship, right? So we talk a lot about that in our other videos as well. By the way, if you're enjoying this video so far, be sure to smash the like button for the YouTube algorithm. This helps the channel out. And subscribe if you want to be able to see more videos just like this one, right? So over here, that's when you have a call to action. And even if they don't buy, because they belong to you, this is something that you can scale. So think about this way, right? So the question is, well, how do I get more traffic, right? Now that this thing is set up, this is when you can start scaling to paid ads. That's when you can run ads. And even if you were to just break even, right? Well, you run ads, you're collecting the leads, and now you're able to monetize through somebody else's product right? Even if you break even, breaking even, if you think about it, is a huge win. Why? It is because, remember, this is paying you every single month. I've ran campaigns where I just broke even. But even while breaking even, how do I scale it to, you know, getting over $1 million in commissions? It is because even if I break even, it's a win. Because I'm going to be getting paid every single month as a result of doing this. Now, obviously, I promote my own products as well. It's my primary business. But that's how I like you to think about this. And on top of that, you're still building a list for free. So anything that they buying from you in future is going to be purely net profit. Now, traffic on its own, of course, is a whole new topic that we talk about all in our other videos. I think we've gone on for quite a bit over here. If you enjoyed this video and if you want to be able to watch more of my videos, especially traffic, be sure to binge watch this entire playlist that's going to appear in front of you right now. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below what are some of your biggest takeaways. We're always giving out tickets to our events, and to people who comment below, I'm going to select 3 different random winners. So be sure to let me know what your biggest takeaway is, and if you want to get really good when it comes to traffic, be sure to watch all these other videos that's going to be recommended in front of you right now. This is Ping Jun, and I'll see you in the next video.